Hello, my dear students. Hope you all are doing great, staying home and staying healthy. My name is Miss Romela and I'll be taking your class. So today's lesson is all about the place value, that is of three place, that is 100, 10s and 1s. So let's get into it. Now before we begin with this place value, first we will try to understand what do you mean by digits first. So digits is a number from 0 to 9. That is the number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. These are called the digits. And we use these digits to form a number. Suppose, let's take a 2-digit number. I'll take here 6 and 7. So 6 and 7. I've taken 2-digit number. So together, these 2-digit numbers makes 67. So that's how we use a digit to make a number or to form a number. Here, we are going to learn about 3-digit number. That is, we have the 3 place. That is, the first place we call it the 1s. The second place we call it the 10s. And the third place we call it the 100s. So first, let's try to understand what do you mean by place value. To understand more on this place value, let's try to understand the difference between place and place value. Now place means, place is the position of the digits in a number. That means place tells the position of the digits in the number. So is it in the positions of 1s, 10s or 100, the digits will tell. And now let's go to the place value. Place value is what? Place value means how much the digit is worth. Is it a worth of 100, 10s or 1s? If it is in the 10, if the digit is in the 10s, the value, the digits will be a worth of 10s. Or it says the value it holds. That means if your digits falls in the 10s place, its value will be of the 10s. If it is in the 100, it will be a value of 100. That's how we find the place and the place value. Let's try to understand this concept with some of the examples. Let's take, I'll take here a 3-digit number, that is 4, 7, and 2. And let's try to find out place and place value. Now here in this number, I have this number that is 4, 7, and 2. First, let's try to find out the place. It says place, it says, is the position of the digits in the number. Now here, let's start with the first digit, that is the 4. Your digits 4 is in the hundreds, so the place of 4, that is the digits 4, is in hundreds, so we write as hundreds. That is place of place of 4 digits, that is hundreds. So that's the position of a digit number 4. Now, what about the place value of this 4? So, place value of 4 is, that means your 4 is in the hundreds, that is 400, so we write 400. Now let's go to the next digit number, that is 7. Now let's find out what is the place of 7. So place of 7 is the place 7, that is the digit 7, is in the tens place. So we write tens. Now what about the place value? Place value of 7, that is 7, will be, since your 7 is in the tens, so 7 times is 70. So that's how we find out the place and the place value in a number. For here, for 1s, that is your digits number 2, will go in the same way. That is, for the digits 2, that is the place of the digits 2 is, your 2 is in the 1s place, so we write as 1s. Now what about the place value? We write as place value of 2 is, since your 2 is in the 1, so 2 1s is 2, so 2. So that's how we find the place and the place value of the digits in a number. Let's take one more example. I'm going to change the number. I'll take the number as 2, 4, and 0. Now let's try to find out the place and the place value. First, let's start with the first digit that is 2. That is place of the digits number 2 is, the 2 is in the 100, so we write as 100. Now what about the place value? We write as place value of 2 is, the 2 is in the 100, so 200, so we write as 200. Done? Now let's go to the next digits number. Let's find out first the place, that is place of the digits 4 is, the digits 4 is in tens, so we write as tens. Now place value, place value of 4 is, your 4 is in the tens, that is 4 tens is 40. Now the last digit, that is place of 0. Here your digits number 0 is in 1, so we write as 1s. What about the place value? Place value of 0 is, since your 0 is in 1, so 0 1s is 0. Done? So that's how we find the place and the place value. Hope you have understood the difference between place and the place value. I repeat, place is the positions of a digits in the number. It can be in any position. It can be in 100, tens, and ones. The place value means how much the digits is worth. Is it a word of 100? Is it a word of tens? Is it a word of ones? That is decided by the position of the digits in a number. So that's how we find the place and the place value. Now let's try to find out how to count in aunt and bag in ones place, tens place, and hundred place. Now the second one is to count aunt and bag in ones, tens, and hundred. Let's go for 100 first. Let's go for the ones, sorry. Let's go for the ones. How do we count aunt, that is forward and backward, in ones place? Let's take a number, that is, I'll take three digits number, 400 and 242. Let's take this number. Now let's try to find out what numbers comes next. So since we're doing it for the ones, so your next digits number, that is only your ones will change. That is your ones place is your 2. That is your 2 is in the ones, 4 is in the tens, 2 in the 100. So only your ones digit will change. That is your 2 becomes 3. And the remaining tens and hundreds remains the same. That's how we count forward in ones. So how do we go for, how do we go back from here? When we go back, that is 243. So when we go back, your ones becomes one less. So if the question says 1 less than 346, what is 1 less than 346? How to find out? It says 1 less, we will look at the ones place. That is, your ones place is 6, so we will make it 1 less. That is, 6 becomes 5, and remaining 3 and 4 remains the same. So, 1 less than 346 is 345. That's how we count forward, that is, aunt and backward in ones. Now, let's go for the tens. Let's take another number, the 643. Let's count in tens. Now, how do we count in tens? For tens, only your tens digit number change. Here your tens digit number is 4. That is your 3s in the 1s, 4 in the 10s, 6 in the 100. So only your tens will change. Now, what if the question says, what is 10 more than, that is 643. Suppose I've taken the number that is 643. What is 10 more than 643? This is for 10. So only your tens digit change. That is here, your digits 4 is in the tens. So only your 4 change. This is more. So we will make it more. That is, we'll increase it by 1. So 4 becomes 5. And the remaining digit numbers remain the same. That is 10 more than 643 is 653. Now, let's change it and make it as more as less. What about the answers? What about these answers? What is 10 less than 643? How do we find? Here it says 10 less. That means we will look at the 10 space digit number. Here your 10 space digit number is 4. So we will make it less. That is 1 less. That is 4. That is for 4. If we make it 1 less, 4 becomes 3. And the remaining digit number remains the same. That is 10 less than 643 is 633. So that's how we find out. That's how we count in ones, in tens, forward and backward. Now let's go for the hundreds. Let's go for the hundreds. Same thing. We're going to do the same concept. We're going to follow the same process. That is for the hundred also. For hundred, only your hundreds digits number change. That is 100 times in 1. I'll take a number that is 946. If the question says, what is 100 more than this number that is 946? It says 100 more, so we will look at the 100 space. Here your 100 space is 9, so only your 9 change. That is, it says more, so 9 becomes 10. Then the remaining digits remains the same, that is 4 and 6. So here, remembering the place value in a place, that is of 1, 10, and 100 in each place, there can be of only one digit number. But here we have a two digit number, so it's not possible to write 1 and 0 together in one place, so it will move on to the next place. So after 100 is of thousands, so we will read the number as 1046. So that is 100 more than 946 is 1046. This is of a four digit number. You will learn more on this four digit number. You will learn about four digit number later on. I'll change this and make it as, instead of 9, I'll make it as, suppose I'll make it as 5 here. What will happen for this? What is 100? I'll make it this one as more as less. Now here, that is, what is 100 less than 546? That is, it says less, so only your 100 is in the 100 digits number change. That is, your 5 is in the 100, so 5 changed by 1 less. That is, 5 becomes 4, and the remaining digits, that is 4 and 6, remains the same. That is, 100 less than 546 is 446. So that's how we count on and back in the hundreds place, tens place, and ones place. Now, we shall try to find, to form as many three digit number using a given number. That is, for the hundreds, let's try to make as many three digit number using this given number. That is, for the hundreds, tens, and ones, I'll use the digit here for 100. I'll take the digit number as 3 and 2 And for the tens, I'll take the digit number as 1 and 6. And for the ones, I'll take the digits number 4 and 7. Done. Now using this given number, that is 400. 400, the digits number is 3 and 2. For the tens, 1 and 6. For the ones, 4 and 7. So using this given number, we're going to try to find as many 3 digits number. So how do we find a 3 digits number using this given number? Using this given number. So what do we do is we will write the place value chart as ones, tens, and 400. Remember, your 100 digits number will be always in the hundreds place. Your 10 digit number, that is 1 and 6, will remain in the tens place only. And ones, that is your digit number 4 and 7, will be in the ones place. So let's try to find out as many 3 digits number using this given number. Now here, let's start with the first digit number in the 100th place. That is, in the 100th place, we have the first digit number, that is 3. So I'll take this 3 in the 100th place. Done. For the 100th place, I've used this digit number. Now, let's go to the tens. The tens, in the tens, I have 1. So I'll take this 1 and write in the tens place. And for the ones, I'll use the first digit number, that is 4. So up here. So what is this number now? 3 in the 100, 1 in the tens, 4 in the ones. So we read this number as 300. 1 and 4 together, that is ones and tens together. Always when you read the number, always takes ones and tens together. That is 1 and 4, that's make 40. So 340. We got the first 3 digit number. Let's try to find out the second digit number. Here, what am I going to do is, I'll use the same 3. And then now this time, I'm not going to use this one here. What I'll do is, I'm going to use the second digits. Or I can use the same digits here again. Let's use the same digit number here again, that is 1. But here, I cannot use, since I've already used 1, 3 and 1, the same digits, 110, I cannot repeat again in once. So if I repeat again, the numbers remain the same. So what am I going to do is, instead of 4, I'm going to use this next digit, that is 7. So what is this number now? 378. Now, let's take another number. I'll take the same 3, that is 3, done. And now, this time, I'm not going to take this 1. Instead of 1, I'm going to take this 6. So let's bring the 6 in the tens. Now, for the ones, I'll use this 4. That is 4 here. So that makes 364. Remember, you cannot repeat the same numbers. It should not be repeated. The number that is a 3-digit number should not be repeated. It should be different. That is 364 I have. Means I've used this number, that is 3, digit 3, 6, and 4. So I can use here again like this, 3, 6, and 7. I've used 3, 6, and 4. So I'll use 3, 6, and 7. That is 3, 6, and 7. So I have this number 367. Now, I've already used this 3. Now, I'm not going to use this 3 again. Instead of 3, I'll go to the 2. That is the 2. So, we'll do the same process, that is 400, tens, and ones. So I'll start with this 2. So I'll write 2 in the hundreds. 2 digits is for the hundred, so remains in the hundred. And then 2, and then I'll take this 1. Same process like how we did. 2, 1, and 4. So I'll write 2, 1, and 4. So what is this number now? 240. So for the next digit, I'll do the same, that is 2, 1, I've used 2, 1, and instead of 4, I'll go for 7. is 2, 1, and 7. Done? Now let's take again. This time, since I've used this 1 2 times, twice, I'll go for the 6 now. So, I'll take this 2, same thing, this 2 in the hundreds, and then instead of 1, I'll go for the 6. That is 6, and then I'll go with the 4 now, 4 digits, that is 4. Done? So, we have this number 264. So, I'll take again one more. This time, I've used 2, 6, and 4, right? So now I'm going to use 2, 6, and instead of 4, I'll go for 7. That is 2, 6, and 7. Now I've already used 3 in the hundreds place, and here 2 in the hundreds place, so there's no more number, so I'm going to stop here. So this is how we form, this is how we make as many 3 digits number using the following. That is using the given numbers. So, till now, what we have learned is we have learned all about the place value, how to find out the difference between place and place value, and then we also have learned how to count on and by in the ones, tens, and hundreds. And lastly, we also have learned how to make as many 3 digits number using the given numbers. So, sure, you might have understood, so I want you all to start practicing with some of the questions from the books. Until then, stay home, stay safe. See you in the next video. Thank you.